Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Blank Dream. Let's get started with it. All right. Goes in here. Let's see. Patrick, I don't have anything for that. Let's see. I had a little help, and I was told to go down only the broken ones. Let's see. Aha! Here we go. This book. Zbira, with an odd air about it, has a book with a blue cover inside. Let's take it. Mathieu found value in the book and timidly took it. Got a blue book. Alright, now what's gonna happen to me? A natural gap. Alright. Looking. Plus a boob. Oh, god damn it! Okay. That. Well, I knew something was going to happen, but I wasn't expecting that. Alright. Okay. I couldn't go up. I don't know why. Okay. Alright. This is gonna make me mad. Let me practice again real quick. Getting right here. Go. I go. Okay. You're lagging. Why? Take it. Okay, got the blue book. Seriously? Are you fucking kidding me? This is... Man, pissing me off. It's pissing me off. I don't trust going there. I don't want to pull over. Run! It's on your own. Uh-huh, that's what I thought. What's that? A notebook rests on top of the desk. Take it. To a quick read of the book, it turned out to be a manual on using lamps. Got a manual. She'll learned how to adjust the wick of her lantern and can adjust its intensity with something that makes fire. Just the lantern can be done from the menu. Alright. What? What's this? Here lies Mishiro Usui. Mishiro Usui has died. Obviously. Mishiro Usui, dead. Mishiro Usui. Or Mishiro Usui's evil will never again open. Her eyes will never again open. I don't know where I got the word evil from. Mishiro Usui speaks no more. Well, okay. Save. Okay. Let's go. Ha, it's on. Okay. I don't know where to go. Okay. Looks like a closet. Open it. Okay, I guess I won't open that anymore. Guess I won't open that one. Drawers, open. Nothing. An angel-like statue. Okay, what's over here? Oh, got ourselves a little prison cell. It won't open. Okay. Let's see your entrance to... Let's go this way. It's mirrored. Drawers. How about you? Can I open you? Closet. You can't open this. Angel-like statue. Wooden stool, glass, and a wine bottle. Okay, I guess there's nothing in there for me to do. Let me save again. Alright! Right up in here and save. Let's go to that. Scared. Where am I? Top left on the right, bottom left on the left. Top left on the right, and bottom left on the left. Strength. Top right, bottom left, and then bottom left, and then bottom left. What? I don't know, I'm so confused. Just weakened. Okay. Top left on the right. Bottom left on the left. Top right, and then bottom left on the lower left. Huh? I don't fucking know. Let me see. Reread that again. I have to go right there, I'm sure. Nope. Shut up. Top left on the right. Bottom left on the left. So, top left on the right. And then bottom left on the left. Top left on the right. Bottom left on the left. Oh, here we go. Okay. I did it. Some puzzles. What are you? That's hers. The mirror shows Yuji's reflection. It doesn't seem to change as much as Mishita looks. Okay. Interesting. I guess I'll go get her. Two in such a short time. Leave me there right away. If we're to get even those one, okay. Enter automatically. Go ahead and save right there. Shows you just reflection. Okay, think I'm getting used to this now. The mirror's got my past, my memories. You know, I'm thinking surely they show memories with something to do with my wish. If looking in the mirrors might tell me my wish, I'm excited but a little scared at the same time. 7 years ago, Mirror Lake. Pretty sunset, huh? Pretty sunset, huh? Utsuro. Sunset is a witching hour. This moment's beauty comes from it being when the sun dies. Even though we see the sun for 12 hours a day, we always forget its beauty. I guess. But I like the sun in the day, too. You're positive about everything, Yuzu. It's been a year getting to know Utsuro. I still haven't been able to tell her how I feel, but we're together as best friends a bunch. Of course, I still like her romantically, but just spending time together, period, is nice. Twilight is a facetious thing. It's neither day nor night, and people spend it preparing for their coming night. Twilight isn't watched and enjoyed. It's just empty and hollow, much like my name. Is the sunset making you sentimental? I think Utsuro's a great name. A great name? I hate it. To be called hollow. It feels more like a denial of my existence. But I like how it feels all translucent. It matches your mysterious air, too. Is that right? Da da da. Da da da. You know, Yuzu, I'm a person who shouldn't exist in this world.
Huh?
What's this now? Just the fact that I'm alive is a mistake. My existence is a cluster of sin. You mean like original sin? Did you ever tell me you were Christian, Utsuro? I don't mean anything like that. In a more concerned way, I shouldn't exist. I don't get what you're saying, Utsuro. I mean, isn't shouldn't exist really extreme? We get along so well. If you didn't exist, what would I do? If, hypothetically, I were to die soon, then you should forget about me. I can only blankly listen to Utsuro, whose words felt so disconnected from reality. It was as if Utsuro saw something different, and I couldn't perceive things in the same way. Yeah, I remember. Even as I got closer to her, Utsuro was a strange girl. Though that was charming in a way. Most of my memories of Utsuro are back now, and now I know these are important memories to me. I still can't remember up to my death, but it seems I remember some things precious to Yuzu Hanasaki. And it's thanks to you, Mishiro. Really, thanks a lot. Oh, I know. Take this. Utsuro got a mystery key. I picked that up earlier, but I don't know how to use it. I'm sure it'll be useful to you somewhere. Maybe. Okay, let's return. Tell me if there's anything else. Go ahead and save you. What about you? So young lady, you're remembering who you are bit by bit. To wreck our memories, bring our wish. What happened to those deceased after that? I'm sure we'll be at peace and go to heaven. It doesn't seem to change as much as Mishiro looks. Let me go get him then. Tell him that I found his mirror. What? A mirror? What? A mirror of mine? So I'll get my memories back if I go there. Alright then, let's go. Sorry to trouble you, but leave me there. Yada yada yada. Those went out. Shows Ryotaro's reflection. Now this is something, no matter who stands in front of the mirror, always reflects me. Or, yeah, that. Not some kind of match trick, is it? Whew. Better brace myself. 5 years ago, a phone call. Ooh, I wonder what's gonna happen. Hello, sis. What are you calling about? That young girl on that New Year's card photo, is that your daughter, sis? Can't you tell? Would I put a photo of a mother, a father, and a stranger for a card? Huh? I suppose. So what about her? Oh, she just looks like you when you were a kid, but at the same time, much too cute for that. Ryotaro, you're making fun of me? Trying to start something? I'm complimenting her. Something about her is just, oh, so adorable. Maybe she gets it more from him than from me. And I'd appreciate the compliments more if you're tasting and giving me such a chill. Now stop misunderstanding me, sis. I'll have you know it's nothing likely. I don't know, creeper. There's a little pedophile here. You can't hide it. The whole Sengoku family trades rumors about how you've got a thing for kids. Seriously? Just try asking Mom. But it's really not that at all. I don't see the way, truly. You're turning 30. Think about marriage already. The bride should clear up any strangers. Tucking my ear off as usual. Oh well, regards to your daughter. Yeah, bye. It's really not anything weird. I just see such beauty there. I see. I remember. Boy, what a mean mirror. My memory like this, of all things. Suppose I don't need to ask if you saw that, too. Stay away, creep. You like little kids? No, I'm not after any sick desires. I just see them as a kind of beauty to be held in high regard. I have no desire to trouble them in the least. I understand that. So aren't you going to break the mirror? Break it? Why? I mean, perhaps it's a memory I'd have been better off not remembering. But it is in fact my memory, and I'm dead already. No sense throwing a fit. Well, anyway, I should thank you. With that, a piece of my memory has returned. Now, no more to do in this eerie place. Be sure to let me know if you find another mirror. If I remember correctly, there was another mirror that I had to go to. That was a, I forgot where it was too. Figures, right? So we're down here. Shows your target reflection. Okay, I'll go get him. He found another mirror. Can it truly be found so quickly? All right then, let's go. Sorry, trouble, but leave me there. Yeah. I know. Hey, go down. Okay. Save. The mirror shows Ryotaro's reflection. Now, what will it be this time? Can't imagine what'll come up, even though it's about me. I wonder if the return of a new memory would totally invert my present personality. That may well be the same as death. No jokes about how I'm already dead, please. You're already dead, so. 1 year ago, a company. Should we get going, Sengoku? Yep, are you worn out, sir? Yeah, trouble at home lately. At home? Ack, is this up to something again? She seemed upset lately. No, not that. Well, it's not that kind of thing, but you are not a stranger. See, my old man's inheritance is proving to be kind of a mess. The inheritance of a friend artist, eh? I'll bet it's a lot. Huh? But didn't your father pass away last year? Why is it only a problem now? Actually, it has been trouble ever since then. I'm the eldest son, but the will says everything should go to someone else, except they're refusing it. That said, they won't even give it to me, so it's up in the air. What was that old man thinking? That really does sound messy. With money, you should always follow the law. That's what I intend to do. Soon I'll get a lawful interpretation at a suitable place. With this taking up all my time, I didn't realize how I've hardly been talking to my daughter lately. This is a delicate time for her, too. This is no good. As a father, I should. Calm down, sir. Are you okay? Right, sorry. I should at least do my job properly. I know, Sengoku. Will you come over to our house later? Huh? To your house, sir? I'm sure it'll take her mind off it to talk with her brother. And if you could, talk to my daughter like a good uncle. Your daughter, you say? There's been some trouble. She's been retreating into her shell lately. She doesn't have many friends at school. I feel like she needs some new relationships. Well, I wonder if a clumsy fellow like me could have a good talk with her. It's fine. You're a good guy. I'm sure somebody like you is just a guy to help my glum daughter. It's pathetic as can be that we're too busy with money to tend to her. But this is important. We can't ignore it. Alright then. If my brother-in-law insists, how can I refuse? Sorry. Hey, wait. Have you seen her before? The cute young lady in your New Year's cards, right? Right. I wouldn't mind taking some time to brag about her, but it's time. There's work to be done, yes. Okay, now let's go. The West Building, right? Yep. Is he my uncle? Da da da. Da da da. Ah, I remember. I see. Mishiro, you're... Da da da. Shinjuku Usui, no doubt. He was my boss and brother-in-law. Though at the moment, I can't recall if I ever did meet you in person while I was alive. They seem like trivial memories, but I feel they relate to my death and wish. Many hold your name, but I remembered the fair bit. Couldn't have done it without your effort. Ah, I've got something here. See, Nishido got a mystery key. I picked it up on a rare walk around this world. No point in me having it. I'm sure you'll make better use of it. Now, no more to do in a secret place. Be sure to let me know if you find another mirror. Alright. Secrets or something in here that I haven't found. Check the desks, just in case. Actually, nothing there. Nothing. 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 There's no desk here. Huh. Nothing. Nothing. Okay, nothing with the desks. I don't know. There's no more testing, just sneaking in this room. I've already done all of those. Let's go up here. Yeah. stroke you. See if I'm forgetting something. Where was that one that I forgot, but maybe it was in here. Go ahead and save you right there. Can't go that way. It was that one door. That said, it was like a mystery. Was it you? Nope. Not you. Let me check these bookshelves and stuff too, just in case. Pile of presents. Books on psychological. Okay. Packed tight with books on science. Many books as thick as dictionaries. A large Santa clock, its age is evident. Piano, Michiro can't play. Pretty white dress. Beautiful painting. Be a reflection of East. Mystery key. It won't open. Some sword. Flip. on, let me go push that one back in. Oh, hello. It opened. Yay! What's in here? Oh. Some things cannot be seen when there is light. Okay. Weaken. Okay. Let's see. Darkness stabbed a sword into the unseen corpse. Sword, but I have a knife. Will that help? No. Let me go get a sword down. Western sword. So I unfastened the latch and took the sword. I got a Western sword. No! That's right. Yeah. What are you gonna do about that? Into emptiness. Let me do it this way then. Go ahead and weaken. Okay. Darkness stabbed the sword into the unseen corpse. Should have heard something moving nearby. It's too dark to see in the fireplace. Okay, let's just turn it up there. What area? Fireplace is gone, revealing a ladder down. Descend. Yay! Mine! The mirror shows Miss Yudo's reflection. Look in. Yay! One day ago, a road. You really don't have to see me off. It can't hurt to be safe at night, right? My house isn't too far from here either. Dot dot dot. Then again, since you're black all over, maybe strangers won't even notice you, Miss Yudo. Dot dot dot. Why are you so nice? Eh? I've already served as a model for your sister. There's no further need to care about me, is there? Huh? I mean, I certainly wasn't the deepening or friendship solely to get you to model for her, me. Then what do you want out of me? No need to hide it. You've done enough for me, Ayato. Hold on. What's this all of a sudden? I don't want anything in particular out of you. That can't be right. It doesn't make sense. There can't be any reason why you would approach me without any motive. Personally, I don't calculate motives or pros and cons when I'm making friends with people. Do you, Miss Yuto? Didn't I tell you? To me, interacting with others means getting warnings from my mom and teachers. I did hear you were in such a situation. Then have you already forgotten what it means for people to interact without a reason? My mom does it to preserve her family's name. My teachers do it to fulfill their job of teaching. So what is it for you, Ayato? I don't understand it. You're overthinking it, Miyashiro. I don't meet with you and talk with you for a reason. I guess strictly speaking, it's just whether we find talking to each other pleasant or not. That's all. Dot dot dot. I heard your mom has been disciplining you harshly ever since a few years ago, and that your high school is a very strict all-girls school. But that's irrelevant. Whatever your situation, there's no inherent meaning in people mingling. I first spoke to you because you resemble my sister, but keeping in touch with you hasn't been for any purpose. And that's fine. It's how things are. So loosen up, okay? Dot dot dot. Besides, you like having someone to talk to, right? I think of you as a good friend, at least. I'd be shocked if you didn't think that about me. I didn't mean to say... I'm just kidding. Really, though, enough of all the overly logical thinking, or else my meager dream of seeing you smile might never come to pass. Dot dot dot. Alright, let's go. Mishiro, watch out! Stop it! That's enough! Oh! Okay. Well, Ayato died. He got hit by a car. Dot dot dot. Just stop it. Ayato protecting her from the reckless driver headed toward her and becoming a bloody lump of meat. Mishiro Usui's heart dying in that instant, and her loss of hope from losing Ayato carrying her to Mirror Lake, in which she threw herself in despair. All these things Mishiro remembered. Da da da, da da da. Just as Mishiro regained a piece of her memory, she felt as if she lost something important. Yeah, okay. Realm of Death, Mirror. Okay. There is something else I do need to do, obviously. That's right. The other room. So there's that teddy bear that was up there. It's my sister. Thank you. What is that room? Something over there. What is it? Huh. Interesting. What the hell are you? Seriously. Why is this tiny shit? It's opening. These matches, or what? Yep, stabbed myself. Walked right on the spikes. I didn't mean to do that. I honestly did not mean to do that, but whatever. Whatever. I've got two mystery keys. I'm gonna use them. I'm guessing that's where these go. Now that she's broken all the mirrors, perhaps Mishiro can open this door. Oh, is this the end? Oh look, it's Ayato! Huh? Hey. Ayato, why are you here? Because this soul is necessary for granting your wish. Huh? Hello, me. So you successfully broke all the mirrors. Your wish will soon come true, and this world's purpose will be concluded. What do you mean? This mirror world revolves around you, Mishiro. You hold dominion over it. Once a deceased girl wished at Mirror Lake, I wish my life had never even existed. It was a very strong wish, and to fulfill it, this mirror world was created. It was made solely to realize her wish. The other souls were just extras drawn into it. She should have granted her wish in this world she made, but she wasn't able to fulfill it, because she broke before she could. Just as she created this world, she lost everything, including her memories and her wish. So, not knowing her purpose or who she was, she wandered this world and fell apart. That's in the past now, a concluded tale. Unable to achieve its goal, this world went on existing, sucking in souls who died near the lake with strong wishes. Da da da. Several years later, a girl threw herself into the lake. Amazingly, she had the same wish as the world's creator. So that this world could complete its duty, it chose a new soul to control it. And so, since you carry the same wish, you became a new ruler. Usurping the originator. The wish the world sought to grant stayed the same. Only the person in the center of it was replaced. I was made the ruler of this world. The extra riffraff who feel jealousy towards you still see the broken originator as the rightful ruler. And maybe broken though she may be, she's personally gotten in your way at times. Even so, you successfully broke all the mirrors without even wasting weeks or months being lost. You shattered and erased all remnants of you in the form of mirrors containing your past. Having recorded all your actions, I can attest to that. Dot dot dot. But it's not over just yet. This boy's soul is absolutely necessary for total erasure of your life, because he's simply too significant to you. Without eradicating his soul, your life can't be nullified. So it was none other than you who unconsciously bound his soul to this world, such that you could kill him by your own hand. Dot dot dot. You aren't telling me I have to kill Ayato. What's the problem? You may feel guilty for a second, but right after that, you'll have never existed. Dot dot dot. Mishiro, you're still suffering, huh? If you kill me, you'll be free from your pain. Right after my death, your conflict will end. It's your world, you can make the choice. There's no choice to make. I threw myself in to put an end to it all, and yet I wound up in this world learning all these unnecessary things, led astray. I'm just tired. Enough of this. I've worked hard enough, just grant my wish already. Oh! The moment the knife in Mishiro's hand pierced Ayato, Mishiro lost consciousness. With no time to feel satisfaction nor regret from what she'd done, Mishiro Usui eternally vanished from existence. Not just silence, not just stillness, but void. There, Mishiro Usui was peaceful, free from everything, eternally sleeping in the cradle of nothingness. And her dream was surely a hollow white. Ending 4 fulfilled. Her wish was granted. She was surely happy. Well, I got the 4th ending. Now let's start over again and see if what happens if I kill for me if I chose that I'll kill him. I'm gonna just save right here for now. Okay, Ayato. Huh? Hey, hi, yo. What's up? Go ahead and skip, 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 skip. I'm gonna skip this. All right, and here we are. Let's go with. Oh. There's no choice to make. I threw myself. Okay, so basically, it's all the same damn thing. Enough of this. Okay. Okay, lost consciousness. Is it from what you've done? Vanishing from existence. Not inside the void. People from around the eternal sleeping in a cradle of nothingness. And your dream will show you a hollow white. Ending 4. Okay, it's the same ending. Same ending, okay. Well, guys, that'll be it for this episode of Blank Dream, and when I come back, I will find the other two mirrors and see what that's about. So, until then, see ya.